Right. Today I am going to discuss 2017 Center of Gravitation. First, you have to find the center of gravity of a semicircular arc. That is a wire bent in the form of a semicircular arc. Right? Like this. So, semicircular arc. Right. So, this is a semicircular arc. So you can divide this arc into small pieces, length pieces, right? Like this. So this is the center, right? Now this this wire is symmetric about OX axis. Therefore, center of gravity should be on OX, right? On OX. So you can divide this into small length elements like this. Right? So you take any out of these length elements, you consider general element PQ. This length element. Right? So if you look at this one, this sector. POQ is a sector. So you take this angle d theta is a small change of theta. Right? You can measure this angle theta, small change of theta. So then this length is equals a d theta. So they have given that radius of the arc is simple a. So therefore, this radius is a, then this arc length is a d theta. So, by symmetry, center of mass, capital G lies on OX. Let O OG equals X bar. So you can take this rho is the mass per unit length. Right? So dm, what is dm? Dm is mass of the element . Actually, it's a length element. Length element PQ. Length element PQ. So mass, the length is AD theta. You multiply by rho, mass per unit length. So you get the mass of this element PQ. Right? Then what is X? X is the center of gravity of the element. Now, this is a particle, right? Its center of gravity or center of mass acting at this point, at the same point. So, distance to the center of gravity of this element from in OX direction is this length. In OX direction. So, always you take it. So, that is X. X is for this sum, X is distance to the center of gravity, center of mass of the element PQ in X direction. Right, that is equals a cos theta. Now you can substitute these things in the formula. So this equals x dm over dm. Now if you substitute these values from x is a cos theta, dm is a d theta rho, right, over dm is a d theta rho. Right? This d theta. d theta. So variable in this integration is theta, right? Theta. So theta, how theta changes? Now theta measured starting from OX axis, right? Now if you divide into this, now you are this division start from here, and this division going on like this, right? And when it comes to this point, value of the theta is pi by 2. When it comes to this point, value of theta is minus pi by 2, because you measure theta starting from OX, right? Therefore, if you measure this angle backwards, this minus pi by 2, corresponding limits for this point is minus pi by 2, corresponding limits for this point is plus pi by 2. So you have to measure theta from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, then you get, you cover the entire wire, right? So you have to apply limit from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, right? Here also minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Now rho is a constant, you can take rho out from the integral side and get cancelled. 1a also you can get cancelled, because taking out from the integral side, right, there is a constant. It's constant, you can take integral side. Then you have to integrate only cos theta. If you integrate cos theta, you get sin theta. So you can apply limits minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2 over. If you integrate d theta, so theta is minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. So this equals 2a sin pi by 2 over pi. So this equals 2a over 5. 2a over 5. Right? So this is the first part, theory part, right? Theory part. So when you write this example, you don't write more detail, because you have to save your time. You have to manage time for this sum. Therefore, you have to write, you just write d mass of dm and write the x value and substitute in the formula and find the distance to center of gravity. So now you know center of gravity like that. Then you come to theory part. If you look at the theory part, it is a composite body, right? Form using arcs, right? So you can all these part fix together and form composite body. Now you can all these part you can unfix and separate into several parts. However, so always you when you do this sum, so you can take object, object mass, distance to center of gravity. X direction. Right? Now if you look at this, the object you are given. So this is the object. This is a wire. This also wire. Like this. This is given as P, center is O, right? So, this is R, this is T, this is Q, this is S, like that. So, this is also symmetric about OX axis. symmetric about the x-axis, right? Therefore, center of gravity should be on OX, right? Center of gravity should be on OX because this is symmetric about OX axis. These lengths are given, right? You look at these all lengths are marked in the diagram, right? So you can save time while you can quickly read the sum because those lengths marked in the sum. So then if you unfix the you take the so you this is the always you take the line aligning line that is easier to get like that, right? So all this you take the distances you measure to right hand of this line you take as positive. All distances you measure backward of this line, that means left hand side, you take the negative, right? Like that. Now you unfix this entire body, first you have to take semicircular arc like this, right? Semicircular arc. Then this straight piece, this small piece like this, then this one and this one like this. Right, this is TS, this is O, X. This is O, X. This is also O, X. This is TS, this is O. X like that. So now you separate each of these parts like this, aligning on the same line, right? Then you find the mass. Length of this part is, that is this part, the PR, this is PR, this is PQ, PQ, this is TS, like that, right? You can separate into pieces. Now you can find the mass of this one. This length is 5a. This arc length, this is a sector making angle radian pi, right? So this arc length, this pi, if you take entire circle is 2 pi, then half of the circle is pi arc length. So if you multiply this one is what is the mass per unit length of the straight pieces row, this part is k rho, so you have to multiply k rho. If you multiply by k rho is the mass per unit length for this arc semicircular wire, right? For other part, this one length is given as a, this length is a, this, therefore this a rho, this also a rho, this one is to, length is 2a, then 2a rho. If you add this part, 4a rho, right? Then now you add all these part, 4 parts, then you get the mass of this part. If you take the sum of this four, mass of this 4 parts, then you get the entire mass, then equals k5a rho plus k5 plus 4a. K5 plus 4 times A rho. If you add these 4 parts, you get this mass. The distance to center of gravity is x bar. You take the center of gravity x bar, right? Then K5, this center of gravity is you got that 2A or 5. For this one, center of gravity, actual center of, now we are measuring the center of distance to center of gravity in x direction. So this is the center of gravity of this part is here at midpoint. The distance, this length is a, so a by 2, but this, what is this angle? This what is this angle? If you take this a by 2, this is a by theta equals pi by 3. This angle is pi by 3. So you can take cos. If you take this cos alpha, then cos alpha equals a by 2 over a equals half, right? Then alpha equals pi by 3. Alpha equals pi by 3, right? Pi by 3. So center of gravity is for this one is a by 2 cos pi by 3, that is a by 4. This also a by 4. This is 0. Distance of center of gravity is at this midpoint. Distance in the x direction is 0. Right? Now you can take moments about. Now you say this is symmetric. The object is symmetric. Symmetric. Therefore, center of mass is on O x axis. So you can take moments about O. You measure this distance backward of this line. Eh? So you take minus A by 4. Eh? This also minus A by 4. This also both the you take this is x in this direction taking as positive, right? X bar is minus a by 4. Now, if you take moments about 4, then x bar into k 5 plus 4 a rho, right? Equals k 5 a rho into 2 a over 5. Plus a rho into minus a by 4. There are two terms like this, so you have to multiply minus a by 4 into a rho. There are two terms in two similar terms, you multiply by 2, right? And other terms, if you multiply this one. So this 0 into 2 a rho, right? 2 a rho. Right? X bar is equals k 5 plus 4. So a rho get cancelled, right? A rho get cancelled. So you can take two k 5 get cancelled here. Then you get 2 k a. Minus a by 2. So this equals 4k minus 1 a into 2 into k 5 plus 4. This is x bar. X bar. A by 2 times x bar. X bar means this is OG. OG equals x bar equals this. Now we got OG. Right. Next part, what is next? But they need the center of gravity from P. So you just add a by 2. Then PG equals, you just add this a by 2 plus 4k minus 1 times a into 2 into k 5 plus 4. If you simplify this one, you get you can take a by 2 out, then you take k pi plus 4k plus 3 over k pi plus 4, right? K pi plus 4. So when you say simplify like this, 5k plus 4k plus 3 or 5k plus 4, right? Like this. So this very easy sum, right? Right. Then next part is equilibrium part, right? This sum that is similar is equilibrium, right? So bodies remain in equilibrium like this. This is P, this is O, right? But this semicircular arc, this one, so it is ball is touching, but they say this is at this point is smooth, therefore only perpendicular reaction is there for this one. So you can take S perpendicular reaction at this point, no friction force at the on the wall, because at that point is smooth, right? But here, this point is rough surface, then friction force. Now, normally, this body tends to slide at this point to this side, right? So, therefore, friction force applied against to this. Against you know, this sliding, right? When this arc is actually this line is tangent to this curve, therefore that line drawn to perpendicular line, this point is passing to the center over this point. There's a perpendicular reaction is like this, friction goes like this. Here only perpendicular reaction only, that is here. But how can you say about center of gravity? Yeah, it is on the OP part or this part, right? On the OP, it is impossible OP part because they have given that k greater than 1/4. K greater than 1/4, so this is positive. X bar or OG. OG equals 4k minus 1. A over 2 into k5 plus 4. So this is positive, right? Because k greater than 1/4. That positive means that g is somewhere here. G of the composite body should be in this side, like this, right? So you can take the mass, you know that mass. Mass of this object is this is k5 plus 4 times a rho, this part, right? K5 plus 4 times a rho. So this is the mass, right? Now you can take consider equilibrium about, now you take this point capital A, so you take moments about capital A, if you take moments about capital A, this is OG, you take the moments about capital A, right? W into A But that the fixture force acting to A, that is fixture force, fixture force and R pass to capital A, but therefore no movements from those forces. Then W into what is the length? So you take, when you take moments, you take this angle. This angle you take as alpha. This angle, if you take this angle alpha, you take that angle alpha, then OG sine alpha. Right? Perpendicular distance from A to this force is OG sine alpha. That is this length. Right? That length. This length. Minus S into A. Perpendicular distance to this perpendicular reaction is this length. That is radius A. Right? That's all. All forces, this equals 0. Right? But suppose, how this is equilibrium remain. The equilibrium is possible if this, at this point, this, if S is positive. That means, at this point, this object is touch at this point very well, if S is positive, right? So, in order to keep the, this object in equilibrium, so that S, being S positive, right? So, S should be greater than 0, right? In order to, for the equilibrium, of the body with the proper touch, at so you can take this point is capital B, and B right, S greater than 0, therefore S A greater than 0, right, S greater than 0, S A greater than 0. Now you can, if you take, if S A greater than 0, S, S A, S A is, so if you take this one from one, S A greater than 0, so S A equals W no A here, right? No A here. W O G sin alpha, W O G sin alpha. This greater than 0. So these two terms are positive, that is OG greater than 0. Right? So we have to show K greater than 1. OG greater than 0. That is 4K minus 1 into A over 2 into K5 plus 4 greater than 0, right? Therefore, we can see 4K minus 1 greater than 0, 3 greater than 1, 4, right? So, first part we have to show K greater than 1, 4, right? Then, here actually, if K greater than 4, only this is positive, eh? But you have to show K, so you don't take this one, because finally we have to prove that one, we have to show, because if this is greater than 4, this is positive, but they are asking, we have to show K greater than 1, 4. If K greater than 1, 4, then OG also positive, right? Then next part, then again they say, the next part they say, mass of simple M is hanging from this point, like this, Mg. Again you can do the same thing, right? Mass, again you can take note about capital A. You just take note about capital A, right? So W into W O G sine alpha, so you take this angle alpha minus S A minus M G. So again this length you can take. This is OP sine alpha. This perpendicular distance from OA is this length. This length are equal. This length are equal. So you can take that length from here. This angle is alpha, then this angle also alpha. Right? So OP sine alpha is a perpendicular distance to MG. So OP sine alpha. OP sine alpha equals 0. Right? Then again you can say for the equilibrium of the body again, with proper touch at B, then S greater than 0, right? So now S, what is S? Now S is SA equals WOG sine alpha, WAG sine alpha minus MGOP sin alpha, right? MGOP sin alpha, right? Therefore, it says that this greater than 0, this greater than 0 means WOG sin alpha minus MGOP sin alpha greater than 0. Then sin alpha get cancelled, right? Then we have W into what is OG is, OG is X bar, you can substitute here 4K minus 1 times A over 2 into K5 plus 4. For W, you can substitute this, this is the mass, K5, K5 plus 4 times A rho minus greater than Mg. Mg is a weight, here mass, so if you take a W, you have to multiply by G, right? Because you are taking mass in, if you multiply this G, you get the weight. So if you consider in terms of weight, you have to multiply with G here. You get G, G, G get cancelled, right? Then Mg, OP, for OP you can substitute, OP is this value, A by 2 plus K5 plus 4K, OG, OG is that value, then what is OP? OP is, this is A. This length is A by 2. A by 2 this length. A by 2 sine alpha. A by 2 sine alpha. Right? So, when A get cancelled, this length cancelled. Right? 2, 2 get cancelled. So, you take A rho times 4k minus 1 greater than A. Now you can take, but k, you are given that k equals 1. If k equals 1, a rho into 0.1 minus 1 greater than m. So this means 3 a rho greater than simple m. Right? Like that. 3 a rho greater than m. Right? So it is very simple sum.